second, I think we're batting to all. At least two things. In the book of Genesis, there is an interesting story. Genesis chapter 4. And I believe that some of us will be familiar with the story. There's a story of the young boy called Joseph. While he was in Egypt, and particularly while he was in prison in Egypt, Joseph was a boy that God picked out of 12 brothers, and he was having this series of dreams that was threatening to his brethren. The dream that tend to say that, contrary to the Jewish custom, that the number 11 is going to be the number one, and everybody will be rallying around him. The story that was so bold that says even the father will come and pay based. So it was a very ambitious dream, so to say. A dream out of this world. And as he shared the dream, the people who interpreted began to have ideas. And to make the matter worse, not because of the dream, the father loved him especially. The father loved the mother, so the father loved the boy. And he was the first from his mother. So he was a favorite child. So the brother didn't like it. And then this dream was getting very frequent. So they decided to do something. To do something before this dream will now become a reality. So in the process of doing something, there was some suggestions. Eventually, they sold him into Egypt. And as he was going to Egypt with a group of Ishmaelite traders that bought him, God was going along with him. When he got to Egypt, he landed in Ikoyi or Maitama district, you know. He landed in a good place where all he needed to do was just to keep the house. And because God was with him, they gave him a favored position. So food was not a problem, clothing was not a problem, sleeping, waking up was not a problem, mosquito was not a problem. He was living a good life, although he was still in slavery. But along the line, because the wife of the chief that he was sold to had interest in him and he would not compromise, he landed himself in prison. In prison, God was still with him. As soon as he got to prison, the chief warder just gave him a good position to be overseeing all the other prisoners. So as he was overseeing them, they now posted him to a special place to serve the kings, the prisoners of the king. So that's like an executive part of the prison. So the guy was also there. You know, the executive would be different from the, that was a first class place in the prison. So things were also still moving, he was still enjoying himself. But he was in prison. And while he was in prison, two of the people that were there had different dreams. So he came in the morning, they were not looking at him. He said, "Sir, what's the problem? Tell me, maybe I'm going." And the two of them came, their respective dreams. One was the chief butler to Pharaoh, the other was the chief baker. And when the chief butler mentioned the dream, told the chief butler, this is a small thing, God can handle this. This is what is going to happen to you. In 3 days, this is what Pharaoh is going to do. Pharaoh will call you, restore you to your position, you will just continue your service, you will be discharged and acquitted. Then the other man said, this is a good thing. that position. Let me also tell my own. So, you mentioned his own dream, and Joseph told him that this was going to happen to you. In 3 days, yeah, Pharaoh will also call you, but he will show you to people, but at the end of the day, the man will just pronounce that you should go and be hanged. And it happened exactly as Joseph said it. So let's read from verse 20 of chapter 40. And it came to pass the third day, which was Pharaoh's birthday, that he made a feast unto all his servants, and he lifted up the head of the chief butler and of the chief baker among his servants. And he restored the chief butler unto his butlership again, and he gave the cup into Pharaoh's hand. But he hanged the chief baker as Joseph had interpreted to them. Yet did not the chief butler remember Joseph, but